Welcome, everyone, to Arlington, Texas at AT&T Stadium, site of this year's Goodyear Cotton Bowl, part, of course, of the college football playoff. We are through the opening round of this year's playoff, and now the pressure is mounting in the quarterfinals, a matchup between one side that's had time to rest and recover and another team that's battle-tested, already off one playoff victory. As we'll see, the number 12 seed in this playoff, the Texas A&M Aggies, taking on the number 4 seed in the playoff, the Army Black Knights. 3A Sports College Football, I'm Chris Fowler, here in the booth with Kirk Herbstreit. And here we go, a college football playoff quarterfinal game. We'll see which team's going to be moving on. First down play call coming up. How aggressive will it be? Offense will keep it on the ground here. He's brought down, but not before the gain to the 42-yard line.
It's a good, solid gain. 5 or 6 yards. Love to see that from the running game.
They'll run the option. He's stopped, but he gets a first down.
And that is a good chunk of yardage picked up by the big guy. Sometimes you don't need a whole lot of space created for a fullback. He can simply make his own way.
Here's the option play. Brought down after picking up 5 yards, so 2nd and 5.
One thing about the college game is everybody likes to run a version of the spread. But there's still an opportunity every once in a while for the old fullback to get in there and show you what he can do. He reminds you on that play right there.
The sophomore able to bring him down quickly. Okay, it's 3rd down after that run. And the fullback gets in on the action with the carry. Brought down at the 40. That'll be a 1st down.
It's a good job here by this offensive line and the running back. Listen, these guys have really had a lot to do with why they're in this playoff game, right? So give it to the offensive line in the back. Get the 1st down on this 3rd and short. See what you can do from here.
Stopped short of the marker after just a short gain. 2nd down after that run on the previous play. They're going to run it. And a decent gain there before the defense brings him down.
Just love watching this back run. Gets behind that offensive line, lowers his pads, and gets a nice solid game.
Offense walks to the line for play number 7 of the drive. They make the stop just short of the marker. It's getting 4th down and inches.
Wow, the defense prevented them from getting the 1st down. How about that? Nice job of holding their point there at the defensive line. They came close to getting the 1st, but the defense deserves credit. Now we've got 4th and inches.
Call is a quarterback sneak. And as we break for the quarter, Kirk, it's Texas A&M on top. And the 1st quarter is in the books. What is a huge opportunity for both these programs to get a step closer to a national championship. We expect the teams to have worked through some of the nerves of this playoff game as we begin the 2nd quarter. Back at it to start the quarter. Offense getting set to run a 1st down play. Quarterback's got it on the option. Defense stops him, but that's a solid gain. Well, they feed the fullback here, and the big fella with a solid gain there.
Yeah, there aren't a whole lot of college offenses that still display a fullback. It sure is nice to see a guy that not only can block most of the game, but occasionally get his hands on the football and get some positive yards.
Now it's 3rd and short from the 21. Defense trying to make a stand here and prevent a touchdown. They'll try to run for the 1st down.
Great job here by this offense being able to convert. Let's face it, they dug themselves a hole. They're down here early in this game. And with all this hype, the last thing you want to do is have to punt the ball. Come up with a conversion. Keep your rhythm. Keep your momentum. Stick to your playbook. Good job here. Now let's see if they can keep that rhythm going.
Oh, the ball comes loose. They scoop up the ball. It's still a live play here.
Well, just like running backs, quarterbacks have got to do a better job of having awareness and taking care of the football. Felt like he got the ball away from his body there a little bit, allowing it to be knocked free. He caught a break because one of his own teammates was able to see that and get on top of the ball.
To throw, it's Bolden. Oh, and he can't hang on for the little screen pass there. That's going to bring up third.
Well, this defense has been incredible all year long, and they continue to be that way in the postseason. Just getting after this offense, whether it's putting pressure on the quarterback, great coverage downfield. Right now, they are dominating this game.
The pass is off target, yet hit as he threw as the third down pressure works. This one is right through.
I was watching this guy in pregame. He has got a strong leg. Not surprised here he's able to put 3 points up here.
The field goal, the kickoff team is out there now. And he'll bring it out from inside the 10. And he's tackled at the 21. That's where the drive will start. Here comes the Texas A&M offense back on the field. Remember, last time they scored a touchdown. Can they keep clicking here, or the defense come up with a stop? And that's good for a first down near the 40. The running play gives the offense a fresh set of downs. Play action here on first down. And he just throws it away there. Safe move. Had nobody open. Second down after the incompletion. Here's the snap. Offense looking to throw the ball. It's a screen pass complete to the running back. They make the tackle, but not before a solid gain on that pass. They'll run this play from the pistol formation. And third and short, they hand the ball off. Breaks loose at the 40. Breaks clear, end zone ahead. And a huge gain. They finally bring him down at the 11. And the Aggies will hustle to the line to run the hurry-up offense. Running game is working. They'll stick with it on first down. That's a nice tackle there by the senior. Coming to the line on second down. This is important. They want to avoid a third and long. Pre-snap motion from the offense. And the quarterback tucks it and takes off as a design run. And he's pushed out of bounds after a short run. Not enough for a first. Here we go. Third down close to the goal line. They can still get a first down without scoring. Looking to pick up the first down through the air. Makes the grab in the end zone. Touchdown, Texas A&M.
Well, that's a thing of beauty right there. Good job all around. Offensive line gave the quarterback enough time. Quarterback puts it right on the money. And with this receiver running a route like this, makes it pretty simple. All you have to do is get his head turned around, catch that football. He's already in the end zone for the touchdown.
Try to add to the lead now with the PAT. And the kick is up and good. They tack on a point to their lead. And the Army offense comes back out onto the field. This is not the time to settle for field goals. They've got to find the end zone here. Jukes to get free and tackled after a small pickup there.
See, that's how you limit what an offense wants to do. This time, the defense just won the battle up front at the line of scrimmage, not giving up any big plays. Everybody's gap sound. It's really solid defense on that play.
And they try to run inside, but nowhere to go.
Well, Chris, this is going to set up a big third down now for this offense. They're down early in the game. All the hype and the pressure on a playoff game. You don't want to dig yourselves too big of a hole. They got to keep this drive alive, so they need to convert right here.
Incomplete. He was hit as he threw the football there on third down. And they're fourth down, they'll punt it away here. And here's the fair catch by the return. And the Army offense comes back out onto the field. Not a whole lot of time remaining before halftime. They cut into this lead. Nowhere to go here, and the ball is knocked loose. Looks like the offense able to recover it there.
Well, just like running backs, quarterbacks, when they decide to pull the ball down and run, they've got to protect it. He left it out away from his body exposed, and it got knocked away. He's very fortunate he had a teammate who was able to get on top of it.
It's incomplete. He took a hit as he threw the football, and it brings up a third down. See if the offense can move the chains off that incompletion. Drops back, looking to throw for it on third down. Oh, he misfires again, three in a row. And the Black Knights will line up to punt it away. They're going to kick it away for the second time. So from his own end zone, he gets the kick away. Returner decides to fair catch this. And here comes the Army offense onto the field now. They'll try the option play here. A gain of 2 yards. Now it's second down and 8. Handoff with a single back formation. Tackled behind the line. It's a loss of 2.
Boy, how about this defense? Just so physical against the run. These guys have not been able to do anything on the ground, and it's because of that defensive line and those linebackers taking away the run game.
Quarterback looks to his right and finds his man. You bring him down, but he makes the 40-yard line. That's a solid game.
Good job by this offensive line and a great throw by the quarterback to get that first down there on third down. Exactly what they needed to do. This is too big of a game. They've come too far. They're in the playoff. You're down in the second half. Good job of keeping this drive alive.
Second down play coming up for this offense. That's a design quarterback keeper. And he's tackled, but only after picking up a first down. And the Black Knights look to keep this drive moving. Back in motion now. He shreds the tackle. Offense getting set. Second down play here. They're going to run the option. Tackle made, but the game moves the ball to the 30. Still looking for that elusive touchdown, but finally this offense is moving. First down and 10. We'll try to run it with the option. Stop after a small gain. Now looking at second and 9. There's some pre-snap movement in the backfield. Tackled behind the line. It's a loss of 2.
Chris, great job here by this defense. They're trying to bounce this to the outside, take advantage of his speed in the backfield, but no chance at all. Defensive speed, ability to diagnose the play, blows it up.
Quarterback finds a target on the right. It's complete. The defense stops him short of the marker, so it's fourth down coming up. So they're short on fourth down, and the coach decides to trot out the field goal team. He made good on his first attempt, but this one is from 47 yards away. With kick right down the middle. Can't hit it any better than that. And the Army offense comes back out onto the field. They've had to settle for field goals. That won't work anymore. They got to find the end zone this time. Tackle made at the 23 as they gain some important breathing room. The guys up front line up. It's first down. It's an option look. They'll bring him down right at the 30-yard line. And as we break for the quarter, Kirk, it's Texas A&M on top. And as we reach the end of three, time is running out in this crucial contest for both these programs to stay alive in the quest for a national championship. Let's check out the game summary before we move on. All right, here comes the fourth quarter. Everything to play for here. Who's going to stay alive, survive, and advance in the college football playoff? They'll run the option. He's wrapped up nicely there by the freshman. Offense looking to keep the drive alive. It's third down. Can he get there on the ground? An effective play. Good for a first down at the 35.
Hey, it's a nice pickup. You got the first down on the ground. That's a great job. But remember, it's a two-possession game. You got to pick it up a bit. This defense will welcome those kind of plays all game long because the clock will keep moving. So you got to put that ball in the end zone and try to get the ball back.
Second down after that previous play. Here's the option play. He has first down yardage at the 46. And the Black Knights come to the line to start a fresh set of downs. Back now goes in motion. Defense will have to adjust. And they'll stop him after a short gain.
Not exactly the outcome this offense was hoping for here on the option. They didn't lose any yards, which is great. I think they're definitely looking for more from that play.
And that's a solid gain before the defense is able to bring him down.
Well, I feel like they called that knowing chances are they're not going to hit a home run. But look at this. Put themselves in a perfect third down situation. It's much more manageable. Now we'll see if they can convert.
Tackle made at the 41. That's first down yardage.
This is why they're in the playoff, right? Not just the ability to throw the ball, but you get to a critical moment, a third down. You trust that offensive line to come up with a first down, and they get it.
They stop him after a six-yard gain, so second and four. The offense readies for play number 10 in this drive. Back goes in motion now. Let's see how the defense adjusts. Eludes a tackle. Tackle made at the 26-yard line. This offense getting closer to the red zone.
You know, offensive linemen are just a certain breed. They're always going to do their job, no matter who's back there carrying the ball. I'll tell you what, they have a little bit more confidence when the person that's carrying the ball can break off some big-time runs. That makes him block just a little bit harder, knowing what he's potentially capable of doing.
And the Black Knights pick up enough for a first down here. And a running play gives the offense a fresh set of downs. Little eye candy here from the offense, some pre-snap motion. They'll hand it off. Finding enough space for a solid gain before they stop it.
Man, you know, the back gets a lot of the attention here. He's a good back. I love to see that offensive line win the battle of the line of scrimmage.
So here comes second down now. Every play important down here in the red zone. He'll hand it off. The game good for just a few yards. The defense swarming to the football. Offense facing a third down now. They can still get a first down without scoring. And it looks like the quarterback's going to run it. And they stop him just short of the end zone. The offense set up with a first and goal now.
You know, even though that these guys are facing a deficit, they're not just going all through the air. Love the fact that you're running the football, keeping this defense honest, not panicking by just throwing every single down. Now you get a new set of downs and a chance to keep moving the ball down the field.
Couldn't quite get there, brought down at the two. It's a second and goal play for the offense. some pre-snap movement back in, and he runs it in for the score. Touchdown, Army. That's a crucial score for makes it a one-possession game and makes the stretch run of this very interesting.
Yeah, now the pressure turns to their opponent and their offense. The momentum is starting to tilt, and it's your job to go into your four-minute offense. But I'd expect this defense to be extra aggressive to try to get this ball back.
Coach deciding to go for two, trying to cut this lead to a field goal late in the game. Quarterback's got it on the option. It's a quarterback keeper. He'll get in there for 2 points. Now the deficit, just a field goal.
Well, there's so many choices here for this quarterback on this option call. That's why it's such a good call on a two-point try. Here, I thought he might run it in. Instead, the defense takes him away. No problem. Pitch it out. Let the back take it in.
And the Army offense comes back out onto the field. The last possession was just old-school power football. Let's see if they can keep that going here. Pass not complete, but there was a lot of contact there, and here comes a late flag.
Pass interference. Defense.
Man, playing defensive back has got to be the toughest job out there right now in college football. You get isolated on islands against these freaky, talented receivers. It's hard enough to be able to stay up with them and try to make a play on the ball, and often you end up bumping them downfield and you get a call like this.
Offense comes out here, one last chance, one possession game. Fires it to the wideout. Catch made on the right side. That's a big gain. Tackle made after a nice pickup on the play. The clock is still running. They've got to get set quickly. Receivers now getting some new assignments before the snap. Caught quickly. In the clear at the 25. Goes out after a nice gain. A sign of life here by the offense. And the player is down injured after that last play. We'll take a timeout or they check him out. The offense really clicking here. On first and 10, looking to throw. Physical defending, that one falls incomplete, brings up second down. And the Black Knights come to the line in the hurry up. Looking downfield, it's Bolden. Looking for his back. And this pass is on target, caught. And he's run out after a big gain. The offense will be set up with a first down and goal.
Well, this offense has a long way to be able to get back and potentially win this game, but they're doing the right things, managing the clock, picking up good yards, and getting out of bounds.
And the Black Knights will line up now. It's first and goal. And the back now goes in motion. Couldn't quite get there, brought down at the two. But crank up the tempo here with the clock ticking down. Second down. On the ground, trying to power toward the goal line. Muscles across the goal line. Touchdown, Black Knights.
Well, hold on now, Chris. We're under 2 minutes to go, and these guys will not go away. They hit this extra point and cover an onside kick. You never know.
They're setting out to try the PAT. PAT is good. They draw within three, 24-21. In these playoff games, it's win or go home. So one side can continue to dream about the national championship. The other side, suddenly, Kirk, her season is over. But it's been a good ride.
Yeah, and I think that's the thing. You know, it's easy to focus on the team that advances. And they should be happy, obviously. They had a great year. They're going to continue to go on. But the team that comes up a little bit short, you know, you can see the emotion down in the field right now. It puts so much into this year. Hopefully they'll be able to learn from this and come back even stronger next year.
And that is going to wrap it up. We enjoyed this one here. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Chris Fowler, and this has been another presentation of EA Sports College Football.